Good morning. I wanted to remind everybody that today is June 3rd, Monday, June 3rd, the day that the Summer Bible Reading Challenge begins. It starts in John. Today you're supposed to read John verses or chapters 1 through 4. And you just continue that pattern, 4 chapters a day, Monday through Friday, June, July, and August. And by the end of summer, you will have consumed the entire New Testament. I really hope you'll join me. I really hope you do. It really has changed me and blessed me so much, and I really want the same for you also. And so the other reason I wanted to hop on today is to tell you something that I just hadn't really thought of. I've been so excited to share this Bible reading plan with all of my friends and with you and other women in my Bible studies, and I hadn't even thought to include my kids. Like, isn't that my job? To do that, and I didn't even think about it. And the reason I didn't think about it is because my kids are 7 and 4. So my 4-year-old son Lincoln, he can only read one vowel words, so obviously he can't really participate. And my daughter can read, but is still at the point where reading is more work than it is pleasure. And so I think if I told her you have to read all of this every day, she would not be encouraged to read God's word more. I think she would really dread it. So then it dawned on me today. I usually accomplish the Bible reading through the audio Bible. Why don't I play it while they're around? Usually I do it while I'm in the shower and getting ready. But instead, this summer, I'm going to try to play it during breakfast, or while we're all getting ready, or while we're tidying up, or while we're on our way to the beach or the park or wherever our summer adventures are going to take us. We did it this morning and it didn't take long at all. I usually listen to it at 1.25 speed because I think the one speed is kind of slow. And so we did that. It did not take long. I should have timed it, but I didn't. I'm sorry. So that will be my main method of getting my kids involved. But also, I just ordered what's called the Action Bible, which is a children's Bible that I have heard is very accurate, like theologically and all of that. But it's set up more like a comic book. So there's a lot more pictures on the page than there is words. And the pictures are pretty good. So I think Lincoln, who can't really read, could flip through the pages and easily recognize the stories and easily be able to tell what's going on. And for Lily, since it's more pictures than words, she could open it up and not feel like, oh, I have to do all this reading because it's really just a few paragraphs on each page and they'd seem pretty small. I just ordered it today. I'll be getting it from Amazon tomorrow. So I wanted to encourage you in those ways to invite your kids to the table. Include them in the feast of God's Word this summer. As you are learning, they can be learning and they can be developing a love for God's Word and a daily Bible reading habit. And how wonderful would it be if, let's say, we did this every summer? If Lily, and Lincoln in 10 years can say, oh, yeah, that's just what we do in the summer. We'd read through the New Testament. That's just what we do. Like, it's just a normal, everyday part of life that will hopefully develop a lifelong habit and a lifelong love for God's word in them. So, I wanted to encourage you today to include your kids. I wish I had thought of it sooner. It doesn't seem like it's that hard of an idea, but it did take me a while to figure that out. So, learn from my mistake, include your kids. Start your Bible reading challenge, be encouraged, feast on the Word of God, let Him renew your spirit, let Him encourage you, let Him challenge you and grow you and draw you closer to Him as you get involved in His Word. I hope you are enjoying this beautiful day, and I will talk to you soon.